My name is Max Fishelson. I'm a third-year PhD student here at CSAIL. I work with Professor Kostis Daskalakis, and the focus of my research is algorithmic game theory and statistical learning theory. So game theory is very important. It describes any situation in which you have multiple agents, whether it be people or machines, making decisions in a shared environment. You know, it's not just rock, paper, scissors, and Parcheesi. It's really going to describe a wide variety of microeconomic situations, setting prices in a shared economy, any sort of interaction between people or machines where my decisions are impacting you, your decisions are impacting me, which is, I mean, essentially the entire world we're living in is composed of agents making decisions, impacting each other. So it's a very important field, and it's very good to be able to phrase these theories in a very general sense, because it enables us to understand connections between the various different parts of our society, where multi-agent interaction is going to define the dynamics that transpire between these agents. So a good example of how game theory has recently interfaced with theories of computer science is in machine learning. So you have this classic model of machine learning, where you have some fixed amount of data, and it's like, okay, we're gonna learn something about this fixed data set. Like, are these images of stop signs or cats? Okay, but more modern machine learning, you know, we have multiple learning agents kind of interacting with each other. You know, you could imagine a company trying to set its prices using some sort of learning model. Well, how you're gonna set your prices is actually gonna impact the economy and impact the world, and then impact how me, another company, is going to be perceiving the world and impact my learning. So now it's like, how I choose to learn is going to impact your learning, and now we're playing kind of a game with our learning algorithms. And so, you know, these classic machine learning algorithms are not going to be robust to these dynamic settings where you have multiple agents learning and impacting each other with their learning decisions. A lot of my recent work has been in the field of studying learning algorithms that are going to be robust to these environments, converging to equilibrium in these games. What an equilibrium is in a game. Okay, you got John Forbes Nash back in the 1950s. He proves that every game has a Nash equilibrium. Essentially, there's like a equilibrium strategy. Even in a game like rock, paper, scissors, right? Like, seems like, you know, there's no great strategy in rock, paper, scissors, right? Because rock loses to paper, which loses to scissors, which loses to rock. But essentially, if you're playing uniformly random over these three options, you're going to be playing optimally relative to this game. And so the task of a multi-agent learning system is to convince, to have agents learning in their own best interests, but also collectively converging to equilibrium in these games. There's many different notions of equilibrium, but like essentially these are the main ideas. Like, you want to guarantee individuals are getting what they need, but also the whole collective system has some structure to it, and convergence to stability points that are good for everybody. Right, so in the general setting of online learning, there's this classic algorithm called the multiplicative weight update algorithm. And this algorithm essentially entails looking at the history of what has transpired and choosing the best thing in hindsight with a little bit of regularity to it. In the last decade, there was this big breakthrough work essentially realizing that with this advent of optimism, slight modification to this algorithm, we can do a lot better in the game setting, but it wasn't a fully closed problem. It wasn't clear how much better could be done. Is there really a rapid guarantee of convergence to equilibrium in games? There was a lot of open questions in this field, and through the work that I've done thus far in my PhD, we've managed to essentially close the research in this direction by establishing near optimal rates of convergence in these games. We came up with new perspectives on viewing the dynamics of this algorithm in such a way that we were able to achieve tighter bounds on even the adversarial worst case regret. And then we were able to prove this thing called high order smoothness, okay? So high order smoothness is essentially a characterization of the dynamics of learners in this multi-stage environment, essentially guaranteeing that if we're all learning using these similar algorithms, we can all guarantee that our strategies and what we're perceiving will be slowly changing over time. So I guess the thesis of my theories are that, like, really this game setting is essentially the most adversarial setting you'll really encounter when you're doing online learning in the world. And With the advent of these new proofs, you can guarantee that if you're running optimistic multiplicative weight updates to make your decisions, it's going to be good for you and it's going to be good for everybody if they all do it together. So, I mean, I did my undergrad at MIT too, and I took Kostis Daskalakis' class, Algorithmic Game Theory, and I was like, wow, this is really cool, like I want to learn more about this. So I did some work with him as an undergrad. I'm now continuing to work with him as a PhD student. I really love the community I have here at CSAIL. I'm specifically part of a sub-community called TOC, which stands for Theory of Computation. There's a group that goes, we go dancing on Mondays, we go to like a hip-hop dance class. There's some people I play music with on the weekends. And yeah, it's a really cool community. I'm really very happy with the friends that I have, and definitely the joy that is in my heart helps fuel the research, without question.